Something that has been plaguing Autopilot cars since the beginning of the Autopilot hardware, and that is Driver Assistance Features Unavailable. What causes this? Well, 99% of the time, what causes Driver's Assistance Features Unavailable is parking facing direct sunlight. Yes, especially on a nice, bright day. And now I found this happens more or less in the winter. I've kind of narrowed it down to wintertime color temperature, the exact color temperature of the sunlight in the wintertime seems to affect it more than in the summer. Now, what will happen is when you're parked facing the sun, for some reason, the car will decide, okay, something's going on with the autopilot camera, driver assistance features unavailable. This causes cruise control not to work, autopilot not to work, accident avoidance not to work, pretty much any assistance features whatsoever. Basically, you are in control. You have to do all steering. I know, first world problems, steering, acceleration. I mean, you don't even have basic non-adaptive cruise control at that point. Well, I just because I've gotten asked a bunch of times, you know, what's a fix for this? There really is no fix. You just got to try and park either not facing the sun, off to an angle. And if it does happen and your autopilot features become disabled, pretty much the only way to reset it and get that back is to park the car, get out, leave it for, you know, anywhere from 10 minutes to a few hours, and then come back. And otherwise, I thought of this, and I've been using this for a while. And this is this one's got a Mickey on it because it was cheap. It was only $1. This is a sticky pad that you can put like on your dashboard and put a phone on it so it doesn't slide around. I use this for sticking in cameras, action cam on my dash, or other stuff like that. So I thought, give it a try. And I started doing that on non-bad weather days. Now, you gotta be careful. These sticky pads in really hot weather can melt. But that's it. That's all I did. Just when I get out and I have no choice but to park facing a really bright sun like it is today. Yeah. And that's it. And when I come out, I just reach over, grab it, and off I go. Doesn't leave any residue behind. At least it hasn't yet to this point. And I suppose if you put it in your car, then you could shove your phone on it. But there you go. That's been my little hack. And I mean, autopilot hardware has been out, and this affects autopilot 1 and autopilot 2 as of today. Which is March 28th, 2018. So for over 4 years, this is an ongoing problem that Tesla has yet to address. And I'm sure engineering is getting tired of me doing a bug report, because I finally have given up, because that's a disabling safety features, and I can't see of any reason why that would happen. Really sucks when you got a really long drive and you don't have the option to park it and come back an hour later. But yeah, I mean, if they could at least give us, regular cruise control, I mean, that would be fine. I can live without autopilot. I can't live without cruise control. It's just too tempting to let the weight of my steel-toe shoes press that accelerator a little more, and all of a sudden I'm doing 155 miles an hour. Oops. Usually available at a dollar store. Otherwise, I put a link in the description box below where you can get these on eBay, free shipping for, you know, a dollar or two. So there you go. I'm gonna try a suction cup one too, but I just think that would be a little too difficult. And the nice thing about these is if it gets dirty, because they are a little tacky, that's how they stick. All you have to do is run it under the sink for a few seconds with some soap, and then let it air dry. And everything just slides right off. When these are wet, they don't stick at all. When they're dry, they get tacky. So, hope that helps. Driver assistance features unavailable. Come on, 4 years, 4+ years, and still affects us.